The foreign ride-hailing service InDrive resumes operations in the Philippines after being suspended for not complying with the country's regulated fare matrix. A transport group says InDrive provides better opportunities for those on the road. Andrea Taguines reports.
Ride-hailing app InDrive is officially back in business in the Philippines. The mobility firm relaunched its services in Metro Manila on Friday following a five-month suspension over its fare haggling system. See, InDrive's unique proposition was that it lets drivers and passengers negotiate for fares, after which both parties have the freedom to accept or turn down the transaction altogether. Despite InDrive's initial accreditation, the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board, or LTFRB, ultimately decided that InDrive's business model violated its fare system, which provides a flag-down per-distance, per-minute, and surge pricing scheme. InDrive said it has now made the necessary changes.
And now we are fully compliant within regulatory requirements and our pricing determined by applications. And only application can set price within regulatory requirements, I mean minimal and maximum price limits.
But without that feature, what now makes InDrive different from other ride-hailing services? InDrive said passengers still have more flexibility and freedom in choosing their drivers, since the app allows them to browse through a driver's rating, car model, and history on the road before booking a ride.
On driver's side, drivers have freedom to choose their own ride, for example, where they want to go, which direction, how far is it pickup locations.
As a new player, the challenge for InDrive now is the onboarding of more drivers.
We have around a few thousand already onboarded drivers with us. But we are on the initial stage of our launch here. That's why the amount is a little bit lower.
To encourage more applicants, InDrive signed a partnership with transport group Laban TNVS, which it said is also proof of its commitment to protect the welfare of its partner drivers. InDrive will implement a 0% commission rate in the first 2 to 6 months of its operations, after which it will only charge a 10% commission rate from its drivers, lower than that of its competitors.
Matagal na po nating panawagan sa ating gobyerno sa LTFRB na i-regulate ang mga commissions ng transport network companies from 23% to 10 to 12% maximum. Nung lumapit po tayo sa InDrive, nagkaroon po kami ng pag-asa sa malaking kita po ito sa mga drivers dahil isipin mo, additional 10% ang kita nila every day, kada pasahero. Mas malaking kita, mas malaking uwi sa pamilya at makakakain at makakapag-aral ang mga bata, mga anak ng bawat driver.
InDrive's four-wheel ride-hailing services are now also available in Bacolod, Baguio, Iloilo, Butuan, and Cagayan de Oro. It plans to expand its operations in Cebu next. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
Jollibee Foods Corporation outlines its ambitious five-year roadmap to becoming one of the world's top five restaurant companies. This after it exceeded its profit outlook for the first quarter of the year. JFC President and CEO Ernesto Tanmanchong says they aim to triple the group's value in terms of profit and net income attributable to parent. The fast food giant hopes to achieve this by expanding the Jollibee brand globally, growing its coffee and tea business, and sustaining its market leadership at home. They also hope to expand its business in China despite the still fragile recovery of the world's second largest economy.
In 5 years, we aim to triple the Jollibee Group's value in terms of net income attributable to the equity holders of the parent company. With our portfolio of strong, valuable brands, the support of our global team, and our consistent efforts to drive the Jollibee Group's long-term growth, we are confident in our ability to deliver on this goal.
Top fundraisers for the Democratic Party grow increasingly worried over U.S. President Biden's chances of winning in November against Trump. CNBC reports some of them described as a disaster Biden's debate performance on Thursday. They're now also urging Biden to stand aside and drop his re-election bid. Several times during the debate, the president would often repeat himself or suddenly stop mid-answer. His voice was also raspy due to a cold. The performance of the 81-year-old leader has raised concerns on whether he still has the energy and stamina for a second term of 4 years. As for currency movements, the U.S. dollar inched slightly higher in Asian trading as markets lift their bets on a Trump election victory. The greenback climbed by as much as 0.1% as Trump reiterated plans to impose a 10% duty on imports. The move could accelerate inflation and delay much-awaited interest rate cuts.